Welcome to our 2020 edition of the Collegiate Carols. The annual carol service was introduced in 1913 by the principal at the time, Miss Anderson, and has become a much-loved tradition. The singing of carols this year was to have been the 108th presentation of carols by the Collegiate Schools. However, the worldwide pandemic of COVID-19, with the restrictive protocols of mask wearing, physical distancing and no gatherings, has ruled out the clustering together of 850 girls on the stage of the Feather Market Centre this year. Restricted to our homes during lockdown, we asked ourselves if this was to be the year that history would repeat itself with no carols performance taking place. Only once since 1913 has there been no performance, and that was in 1944. That summer, South Africa was battling an epidemic of the poliomyelitis virus, so all schools were closed early to prevent infantile paralysis. However, the difference between 1944 and 2020 is technology, and this year the music department is utilizing the digital platform to keep the tradition going. The collegiate community worldwide can once again experience the annual highlight of the uplifting Christmas story sung so beautifully by the collegiate girls of previous years. Each year, the proceeds from the ticket sales are donated to the community chest to assist those in need. At the end of this service, there will be a link for you to make a donation so that once again, those in need can benefit from the giving hearts of the collegiate family. Wherever you are tonight, from the first strains of Adeste Fideles to the Benedictus, may the spirit of the Christmas story be with you and fill you with peace.
Thank you. honoured guests, parents, old girls, the wider collegiate community, and perhaps most importantly this evening, our special Girls of the College. Welcome to the 108th Collegiate Carols performance, and our first ever virtual carols performance. As we begin, shall we bow our heads in prayer?
Heavenly Father, as we gather, each in our own venues around this magnificent country and around the world this evening, to join voices as we sing carols, we thank you for the privilege of being able to either attend or to be associated with this wonderful school. Thank you for the opportunity to come together, even if it is online, and by doing so, remember those less fortunate than ourselves. Help us tonight to also reflect on your blessings in our lives and on your incredible love for each one of us. May your Spirit help us to remember the true reason why we gather this evening, that is to celebrate the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. It is with wonder and awe that we begin to consider your gift to each one of us and to contemplate the depth of your love for us. It has been so easy at times this year to allow the worries and uncertainties of life to distract us from the steadfast rock that is Jesus. Thank you for keeping us safely this year, and we pray that by your grace you will help us to be still tonight, to reflect on your offer of life in abundance, and to examine our own hearts at this special time of year. Thank you for everyone who has worked so hard, despite the trying circumstances, to put this presentation together. Guard them, watch over them, and may their voices and words bring you honor tonight.
Isaiah chapter 9, verse 2 to 3 and 6 to 7. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at the harvest, as warriors rejoice when dividing the plunder. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing it and upholding it with justice and righteousness. From that time on and forever, the zeal of the Lord will accomplish this.
Hallelujah.
chapter 1, verse 26 to 38. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered her, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she, who was said to be unable to conceive, is already in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." And then the angel left her. chapter 2, verse 1 to 7. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken in the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Thank you.
chapter 2, verse 8 to 14. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." Matthew chapter 2, verse 7 to 12. Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time that the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." And after they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother, Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. Thank you. chapter 2, verse 25 to 35. Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon, who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Moved by the Spirit, he went to the temple courts. When the parents brought in the child, Jesus, to do for him what the custom of the law required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you may now dismiss your servant in peace, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you prepared in the sight of all nations, a light for revelation of the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel." The child's father and mother marveled at what was said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "This child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thoughts of many hearts will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too."
Heavenly Father, we stand in wonder and amazement at how great you are. We marvel at your majesty and splendor, and at how you hold the world in the palm of your hands. And yet, you have chosen to love us, to send your Son to be one of us. You long to be part of our lives and to offer us the life which we were created to live. Help us during this festive season to truly remember why we celebrate Christmas, to stop and listen for your voice, to be still and ponder your calling on our lives, and to reflect on where our hearts are at. Give us the strength and courage to not allow the world to block you out, and to daily live our lives in a way that honors you and puts you first. Help us to be men and women who stand for what is right in your eyes, despite what the world or popular opinion may say, and to be people of integrity in all that we do. Help us to listen to each other, respect each other, and to seek to understand before being understood. May we always remember that wherever life may take us, you have promised to be with us, and may we continue to hold on to your truth that when we place our lives in your hands, you have assured us that your plans for our lives are perfect in your eyes, and that you have called us to trust you with all that we are. Our world is in desperate need of your touch, Lord, now more so than ever. So may we be your hands and feet as we choose to live our lives focused on you. Thank you for each person who has watched this amazing carol's performance. May each one of us leave having caught a glimpse of you, having had our hearts touched in a way that only you can, and may we depart determined to live out your love. And now, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.